Welcome back to the Comedy Store Doorcast. I am your host, Luke Schwartz, and with me today I have one dropout and two real door guy homies. We got Jessica Wellington and Guam Felix.
Yeah.
Yes. As always, sponsored by Thirster. Thirster, the cheapest water. It's really good, actually.
It's the thirst trap.
That's very good. We have a few. Before we get into this week, which is a very big week to get into, the main room lobby is closed. That's big news.
It's huge. Yep.
And I have a couple sponsors from this past week, people who tipped at the door. Again, if you tip at the door and mention the Doorcast, we will give you a shout out. That's nice. You're sponsoring our lunch. That's what I think of it as.
Yeah.
Brian dropped $3 in, so that's all you get is Brian for $3. Mike dropped 10 in. Thank you so much, Mike. You rule. Perry dropped 10. I asked for their handles. No one wanted their handles. Oh. They were like, no, don't mention me. I was like, no one listened to this podcast.
That's quality charity when we don't want the clout.
Yeah. Too bad. You're getting some clout.
But can I also shout out Annie Letterman, who tipped $50 to the back door?
Oh, cool.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah. She got that new car, and she was throwing money away.
Wow. That's good.
It was nice. It was very nice of her, though.
That's great. Thank you, Annie Letterman, for tipping. This is good. Brandon gave some money. I didn't write it down. And then Elias also. Dropped a big bill in there, and that was really nice of them.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to the lady that got in a fight with Anya, but she tipped me $50 the night before.
Oh, yeah. So basically,
Sometimes it's the best and the worst in one package, and that's just who comes to the Comedy Store is like broken.
Okay, listen, if anybody tips $300, I'll let you punch Renee in the face.
Okay. We're not doing tiers of donations yet. We're not going to give away bodily harm on another.
Renee comes around the back with a bloody nose.
That's on our Patreon. That'd be perfect. First level.
Well, Renee would get 150 of that, and then he'd split the 150 between everyone else working that night.
I agreed.
Yeah.
He'd earned it.
So thanks for coming by the back door where we've all been working because there's no front door anymore.
Yeah, everybody's been at the back door.
Yeah, it's been.
But it's going to look nice, I
tonight,
hope.
Tonight, every room is sold out, and that back hallway is going to be tough.
Yep.
Ugh.
Well, it's going to be like almost like we always talk about pre-pandemic, how crazy it was.
Mm-hmm.
It's like from before pre-pandemic, it's probably, in my mind, it's probably like 70% now. The craziness from doing two shows every single night.
Yeah.
Two sold out shows in the main room every night for weeks and weeks, you know? So.
Are you wearing your gator when you're working and stuff?
Yeah, I don't know, man. It's been, I don't know, the ladies like it. So I was just like, you know, I've been rocking it, you know?
How do you know the ladies like it?
Because a girl told me, she said it was cute. So I was like, all right.
One girl told you and you're like, that's it.
That's
all
I need. That's all I need.
I'm wearing a mask and I guess it's just, I mean, I think it does something. I see so many people and like, I don't trust. We have coworkers that come in with a big gulp in one hand that's half full and crumbs all down his shirt.
Yeah.
Oh, I know you don't.
And then I'm going to wear a mask. That guy's unclean. That's not safe.
Right.
Well, I'm going to wear a mask because of them. And like he's going to 7-Eleven getting the thing, getting COVID and coming back.
Yeah.
And so I'm just like, I'll mask up. And like I see like 300 people I'm sitting. I'm going to.
He's the one guy that eats like the pizza and the little.
That's,
But it's been.
Funny dude, though.
Just very another funny. Thing, too. It's been unbelievably cold. I can't even say unbelievably.
Well, you shivered in the middle of
it. Yeah, because when it hits like around 11:30 midnight on the patio, it's been freezing out there.
It has.
So that's why I wear the gator, because I could cover my face, plus put the beanie down in the hoodie, because, man, that air has just been killing me
that
out
makes
there.
Makes sense. Last night, though, was the first time I went to the gym, and I was like, fuck you, I'm not wearing a mask.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
Wow.
Well, there's nobody in there either. When I go late night, it's like, why am I? Half the time, I was like, why am I wearing a mask?
Sure, if you're alone,
no one is around me.
Yeah. I try to not. I mean, I'm doing this right now, but I try to not take it off inside. I don't know. I try and still like give people, but I mean, everyone's vaccinated,
supposedly. But at some point, I feel like I want to get back to normal, and I feel like now our numbers are going down. So what the fuck?
I don't know if. Yeah, I think numbers are just staying. We're not COVID, and let's not, like, we're not, this is not an Austin podcast we can talk about. So, well, let's talk about, like, what it's been like at the store. Have you had any story? You had a tough Friday.
Yeah.
That was a rough night.
Yeah, we had it's very rare that we have to get like physical with somebody here at the Comedy Store. It probably happens like once a month, but for some reason on like Friday we had like almost like three incidences where we almost got. The bottom line was some guy was stupid drunk. Anya had to kick him out, so Anya, you know, like pushed him out through the front, and you know he kept on coming up to me, and he was smoking a cigarette. And he kept on slapping my shoulder, you know, and I told him, I said, hey, man, stop touching me.
Yeah.
And I need you on the sidewalk. You know, I'm very patient. So he goes to the other side. He goes to the other side. And then he nudges Brandon. And Brandon's huge. So Brandon kind of like just pushed him.
How big is this dude?
This dude was probably, he was probably like 5'4", but he had to be a solid 250. Like you could tell he was like. He was thick.
That's really short.
Dude, he was thick.
That's really, really short.
He was probably either he played football or he was like a wrestler.
White guy?
Yeah. White, but he was big.
5'4" white guy?
Yeah.
This story is getting less and less impressive. No, stop.
But the thing about it was when I came over to the side and I asked him, you know, hey man, you gotta get off the property. And then he like grabbed my shirt. So I grabbed his shirt and I was like pushing him like this.
Okay.
And then when I pushed him, he grabbed my shirt and next, you know, we were both on the ground.
Okay.
And I said, okay, so we're going to do this. So I ended up getting up on top of him and his face was on the ground. And then I just grabbed his hoodie and I just started like choking him out with his hoodie.
Okay.
And good. He was sitting there and it was kind of funny because he was still like trying to talk shit, but he couldn't breathe. So he was like, oh man, fuck you, like that, because he couldn't fucking breathe. And I was trying to be cool. I was like, listen, man, I'm going to let you go, and then you can go home, man. You don't have to go to jail or nothing.
We're always so reasonable.
Yeah. I said, dude, I just want to let you go home, man. But he just had to keep on. But then, you know, I was on him for like, I don't know, a good 3-4 minutes. And this guy was strong. So what happened was he turned really fast. And so when he turned, I got my leg underneath him, and then I kicked him. And then he kind of like hit the wall. And
this
then
when is he all got off up, property, right?
Yeah. This was on the sidewalk.
Yeah.
So when he got up, and then I just kind of like pushed him and kicked him away. And then he just started running. Okay. He started running down the street. But he left his shoes.
Ugh.
So I told Anya.
When did he take his shoes
off?
No,
he lost his shoes when we were
wrestling.
In the scuffle.
In the scuffle. He got his shoes knocked off.
Did he literally run out of his shoes?
Yeah. So I knew. I was like, Anya, he's going to come back for his shoes, dude. I know it. So I took his shoes and I put them on the patio. So the sheriff shows up, right? Okay. And, you know, we're talking. I said, hey, man, he's walking down there. You know, I described him. Next thing you know, he just walked up. He was looking down. He was looking for his shoes. So I grabbed him, and I was like, hey, Sheriff, this is the guy. And then he took
them. They're so dumb because I've been in that situation where somebody has gotten away. We've called the cops.
Yeah.
And then they walk by
to
see what's going on with the cops. And like, oh, yeah, there he is. He's back right now. There. You can get him. Like, you fucking idiot. You could have been gone.
Yeah, I have a rule, though, and I've been telling everybody this, that, you know, as long as I work security, I've never punched anybody in the face or hurt their face unless they swung at me or they hit me first. Because if we're going to wrestle or, you know, like grapple or whatever and get on the ground, then we'll handle it. But especially when a guy's stupid, when he's kind of like really drunk.
Shoving.
I don't. Yeah, saying, yeah. Shoving is it's like fine.
Your limit.
Yeah. But
there's that's your threshold.
Yeah. My whole thing is this, because I don't want somebody that's so fucking drunk, and then they wake up the next day and they're like, oh, man, why my face is all fucked? You know what I'm saying? And
right.
Yeah, because then, you know, because I just
feel.
You're
being good at your job.
Yeah, because I'm like, you know, it's like I don't want to, you know, like overkill the situation.
You took the alcohol interference training. What is it called?
Bystander.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which
How was that?
Well, this is the thing.
Mandatory class we all have to take.
Yeah, that thing. Did you take it already?
I have scheduled for next Wednesday.
Dude, it kind of threw me off.
It was good?
Because I thought it was more about like just security stuff, and it basically turned into like a sexual assault like thing about like trying to prevent that in like the clubs and the bars.
Well, good.
But the thing that shocked me was the video, right? You saw the video?
No, I didn't see the video.
Oh, you
well,
didn't,
no
didn't have
spoilers,
the video?
But yeah.
Well, the video was kind of like, damn, dude, they're like, are they going to have to, like, you know, they could have just talked about it. They didn't have to go make, like, a crazy video about it.
I guess.
And it kind of, like,
but it
threw
seems
me
like
off.
It sunk in. It seems like it was effective.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Can I tell you what I learned?
What?
So if you're in a garage and a man is following you.
Okay.
All right? You feel threatened. You have your purse on you. Well, you throw your purse and then you run to the stairs. Now, if that guy goes after your purse, you got time to get away now. Now, if that guy runs after you, you're fucked, but still run, because now he wants to fuck you.
Uh-huh. What if he does nothing? Then it's fine.
I hope
it freaks some dude out, but that's a good strategy to have that, you know, in a garage.
Yeah, another thing too was that but my point being was, as a guy that's been working security a long time, was like, hey, somebody in the group of people that come to, it doesn't matter if it's the comedy store, another bar or a nightclub or whatever, there has to be somebody responsible, because before that was me. I was the guy that doesn't drink and get high. So
okay, that was your experience and whatever. Yeah.
Well, the very next night there was a drunk guy that was at the show. Then he left, and I came outside. We were all going home. He was passed out in front of the patio, and his phone was like on the sidewalk.
What time?
1:30.
Yeah, it's late.
Okay. Something like that.
Yeah,
and I got him up and I got him an Uber because I was like, somebody's going to take your phone. You can't even stand up. He kept like pushing me away not to hold him, but then he almost kept falling. So I'm like, just let me hold you. Shut up.
You got an Uber on his phone?
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. I wasn't paying for it.
No, of course. I wouldn't have paid for that. Yeah. You did great.
Yeah. We get, the thing about it is that we get like the very minimum crazy stuff here when it comes to customers, just because we're a comedy club. Mm-hmm. I mean, working at a nightclub. Dude, there's been so many times where I physically had to go into a bathroom and pick a girl up and pick her up and help her out.
A good night is when annoying customers are like telling jokes. That's a good night.
Yeah.
If that's the worst you have to deal with, like that's a good night. Yeah. I get people. I had a guy coming in going like, "It's a joke." I go, "Yeah, I know."
Yeah.
It doesn't change things.
Let that be the worst thing that happens.
The other night that they were so nice, I kicked them out myself, and they were lovely about it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. They were polite. Yeah.
Right, because they were talking, and then their one guy was falling asleep behind him the whole time. So he was just, and I was like, look, I warned him twice. I was like, you guys have to go.
Mm.
And they were like, yeah, that was my fault. And then they just
left. Great. Wow. That's what a considerate.
Right.
Asshole.
I think, you know, another thing that I want to, I just want to say on this real quick is I think a lot of people come here and for whatever reason, they think they have to be part of the show. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I was one of those people before I started comedy.
Yeah.
Wow.
There's certain people that I've noticed that it's okay to laugh and even like sometimes you yell, like, you know,
I'm not a good audience member.
Yeah. Yeah. But
I sigh pretty loudly. Yeah. And go, ugh.
No, I just
give a ugh. It's not good. I'm too judgmental to be a good audience member.
But you're a comic though, so you get it.
When I went to the Magic Castle one time, and a guy was like part of his patter, and he was close. He was crushing it with the magic, and part of his patter was like an old joke, like a bear walks into a bar. Is like why the big paws is sort of, and I knew the joke, and so I went oh, and I was excited. It was like oh, and he was like oh, if you know the joke, then do it. And I was like oh, God damn it, I stepped on his line. I was like.
Yeah,
bad audience member. Ugh.
Okay. You know what? That totally made me think about something. What was the worst heckle you've guys seen at either here or at a show?
The worst heckle?
Yeah, like you saw a comedian on stage and somebody like heckled them.
Oh, Josh Martin that one night.
Really? What
happened? Oh, the other night.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow. What happened?
They were going after Josh. They
oh,
were
really?
Not a
oh,
fan.
Yeah. He was a little in his cups maybe, and he was like he was just kind of doing his regular shtick and not caring about delivery or whatever. And people were like, "This is," they got upset.
Oh, you know, goodness. That's probably a big part of it because, you know, people watch him go up there and they're like, he doesn't give a shit. Why should we?
Mm.
Huh.
Mm.
I was down. I got
a note to
up.
All comedians.
Yeah.
For real.
That was a good note from Jessica Wellington, who's been in the game and killing it for quite a while. And a bad audience member. Like we all are. Yeah.
You know, bombing. This is another thing, too. Bombing is actually an art. That's what I tell people.
Oh.
Because,
Guam does a beautiful swan dive into concrete. Guam is the Steve Lebeckett of comedy.
Dude.
For my real heads.
Dude, this guy gave me, I think, the best compliment. He came up to me, and this happened like about 2-3 and he goes, Guam, he goes, I've laughed at you harder when you're bombing than some people's regular sets. He goes, I enjoy it when you bomb, dude, so much.
Yeah, you do bomb very well.
Yeah. It's become a choice. You're really leaning into
it. Oh, my God. Well, those late spots in the belly.
I do have a bone pick to pick with you, though, Guam.
What's up?
Okay.
So, you know, I'm in the main room working, and then this guy flicks off Anthony Jeselnik, and I spot it right away. And I come from across the room because I'm with the two door people that don't like confrontation. So I come across the room and I'm like, what the fuck, dude? You got to stop. Apparently he gives me the finger as I walk away, telling him to be quiet, which I didn't know. Found out
later. Course he is. If he's flipping off Anthony Jeselnik, he's going to flip the guy.
Right. And I was like, Anthony's even started. I know he is hateable to some, so, but he didn't even give him a chance to hate him legit.
Yeah.
So I don't know what
he did one joke or what? Like,
yeah, he wasn't even like, did Anthony call it out? No. Oh. He totally ignored the guy. And then, I got him kicked out, which he should have been gone earlier. Mm-hmm. I told him he needs to go, but you know how they drag their feet. But he finally got out, and then you let him back on the fucking patio.
And what happened, though? Did you specifically come in and tell me the guy was done for the night?
I had told everybody, and I told Anthony, and that should have been...
It should have gotten to you somehow. I think it was a...
No, you know what happened? Somebody didn't tell me. Because I'm really good. If I'm on the patio and somebody says, hey, this guy's not allowed back in, then they're done.
Right, like, then he continued on the patio drinking and having a good time.
Yeah, then like, you know what? Then somebody didn't tell me. Because trust me, there's not one time that I've been here in 6 years that somebody's told me on the patio. Because I love kicking people out.
Yeah.
And I love when people...
And sometimes
you're done?
I will say...
you're done.
And
you're done.
Not, maybe not in this case, but some cases I would say, if we kick someone out of the room, like the considerate idiots, the guy who fell asleep.
Right.
Yeah, yeah. If they want to like drink on the patio...
I'm fine with it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you're saying this guy couldn't...
No.
Okay.
I mean, even
being
people
a dick,
in the audience were...
But if he wants to spend some more money here and he just like kick him out or whatever...
Mm. I told Anthony he needed to go and... He was waiting it out, and then even audience members were coming up to Anthony and be like, hey, this guy's acting weird.
Okay.
I was like, you see, he needs to go. I'm telling you.
Yeah, out of the show.
I apologize, though, because nobody told me that. Because there's no way you would have came up to me and told me that, and I would have let the guy right back on the patio.
Yeah.
So, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah.
All right. So. Well.
You know, things happen.
Communication.
Yeah, communication.
Breakdown. Yeah.
Do you think we need radios again?
I don't want them, but they were helpful.
Yeah,
they were.
Well,
I don't want them at all.
If anything, you know what? We be honest with you, the security guys just need them. That's it.
Yeah, but how do we get a hold of you? Like, we're the ones that...
Because there's one in every room, they can hit up another...
You just have one radio that you guys don't even need to be on until you need somebody, and you know, like that.
So what I would say is, like, I tell Guam, hey, can you tell Joe to tell Bruce that he needs to watch the back door or whatever?
Yeah.
Or send him to the main room or send someone to the belly room.
Well, dude, I kind of missed the radios because, man, there was some nights where everybody was on a good one. We were we were dying laughing. I remember Curtis used to get in there, knock it off, guys, because we would just be roasting each other.
Burner was really good on the radio.
Oh, my God, those were fun days.
I wish I could Curtis you guys in the text chain sometimes. Oh, my God. It's enough, guys. It's enough.
Oh, yeah. Well, this is the thing. That's the one thing I love about the Comedy Store, because you got to remember, we're all comedians. We all have great sense of humor. And then it's part of the game. See, this is another thing, too.
Do you think Nene has a good sense of humor?
Yes.
I love Nene, but I don't think that he...
Okay, we were just talking outright shit on a named door guy. Come on, man. Give him a little something.
No,
just do it abstractly. How
much, I don't mean it like that. I think that he thinks that he takes other people way more serious,
Okay, here, let me stop you there. This is the thing, and I want to hear you guys' opinion about this. I've said this since day one, and I've learned this from day one of stand-up comedy.
Maybe we'll cut this out, too.
Listen, if you are a stand-up comedian, you have to have thick skin. Part of the game about being a comedian is that the other comedians are going to roast you and make fun of you because it's just back and forth. I mean, how many times – perfect. Let me give you guys an example.
Yeah, I mean, yes.
This
hallway – No one's disagreeing with
back,
that.
Well,
but that's what I'm saying. Even as door guys here
– I was specifically talking about Nene.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. But there's, so I was just you like... can't – your feelings can't get hurt here. That's just ridiculous. That's just ridiculous. Come on now. Everybody gets
it. It's not ridiculous to get your feelings hurt or whatever.
Yeah,
but don't blow up or anything. Yeah, I understand.
But okay, I don't know if you guys want to get sidetracked, but can we just talk about this real quick?
Jesus.
No, listen.
I guess so.
I want to hear your opinion about this. This is why we have podcasts.
No, that's why we're therapy.
Listen, that whole thing that went
different
down.
Different kind of pod.
Listen, if you guys want to talk this about it, we can talk about it. And if not, I'll just shut it down.
I'm not clear what we're talking about. Go ahead.
Okay, listen. That thing that happened with Tony Hinchcliffe and the whole chink incident, you know, because I could say it because I'm part Chinese. So that whole chink thing, my whole thing was this.
Oh,
if you're a comedian, right, you're supposed to be able to take it and dish it out. And it's all comedian. We're just telling jokes. You know what I'm saying?
I didn't see the video. So I don't want to speak on that.
Yeah, but the whole thing about it, see, that's why I got kind of
I think
mad.
Tony is in the wrong for doing that shit. Mm. It's just like not good and funny, and I think the other comic knew what he was going to do and set him up for it.
Yeah.
And I just don't like the whole situation.
Yeah.
And I'm uninterested in the whole situation. So that's my real take on it.
Okay. But I'm just going to throw this out there. And when I'll end this conversation, I just want to let you guys know
that when Alex. That's Luke's take.
Yeah. I'm going to say this right now and to let you guys know this.
Kibosh on it.
When Alex Duong bring me up, I told everybody that I hate that gook. So I just want to throw that out there and let everybody know.
Okay. You, yeah.
So.
You okay? You could have let it lie, but no one is interested in that either. Like,
okay,
that's...
Okay, let's talk about this. This is interesting. You cannot be racist towards your own race.
Yeah, well, yeah, you can.
Yeah, but part Asian and I talk about, like, that's why that whole chink thing didn't bother me. You know what I'm saying? So what are you talking about? Like, we're all comics. Like, if any of you guys, knowing that I'm part Asian, if you said anything derogatory, that wouldn't fucking bother me. I'd just be like, whatever. Because
being Asian is like the 20th thing that, yeah, that I would make fun of.
Exactly.
But also, yeah.
I just, you know, it's just this thing that I knew from
day
one.
We had this last week. Matt Lockwood kept wanting to say the N-word, and now Guam is just like, hey, do this! Like, what? Great. Yeah, it is the Doorcast.
But
it's the Doorcast.
You know.
And that's Luke's take.
Yeah. But
it is.
The whole thing about it, that's why we're comedians, because we express our freedom of speech. And even if it's something you don't like or something offensive, we're still going to do
out.
It. Yeah.
But you know? The other thing about free speech is other people are allowed to tell you that that sucks.
And that's
where your thick skin comes in.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Sure.
But my whole thing is this. I get mad at other comedians for getting offended by stuff like that. You're a comic. You make fun of everybody and everything. And then all of a sudden, somebody touches one little nerve about your ethnicity and you're mad? I said, get the fuck out of here. That's ridiculous.
Well, you can feel it, too.
He didn't if you're talking about the Tony Hinchcliffe, I'm sorry to talk over you, but if you'd seen the video, he goes in on it. So it's not one little thing.
Yeah.
I understand he's mad. I don't like that he filmed it, and I don't like that Tony did it, but, like, I'm sorry for repeating.
I know, but
repeating.
His show,
I'm
but
just saying,
everybody
you can usually
knows.
Feel when somebody's coming from a place of love or like a place of I support you, and where you come from a place of like fuck you.
Yeah, but I don't know, man. It's just my whole thing is this.
Holtzman writes
and
that line.
You know that
Holtzman
he gives a lot of fuck you vibes.
Yeah, but
I love Hinchcliffe.
Yeah, the whole thing about it, I'm just gonna say this because if you're a comedian and you're watching this, you got to have thick skin if you're gonna get in this game and stay in this game.
Yeah.
That's all I'm going to say. Because I was just upset that they made such a big deal about that. Because if I was there, I would have had a talk with that guy. I seriously would have took him to the side.
Well, this depression, I'm going to clock as shedding my skin, and I got to thicken back up. Then.
Yeah, yeah. So.
T.I. was here last night.
Oh, yeah. How long do you think he's been doing stand-up? Like a couple months? Or maybe
7 weeks.
A couple months, I guess. Weeks to 13 weeks-ish.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you seen him go up on?
Yeah, I watched his whole set last night.
What did you think? I didn't see it last night.
This is the thing. First of all, you can tell he's new.
Well, yeah.
You know, he is T.I., so he's very charismatic. He has great stage presence. He just needs to get up more.
He's not confident in what he's saying.
No, that's why he got to get up more. Do you know how terrible? Dude, I'm going to admit this to everybody. I was fucking the worst stand-up comedian of all time the first, like, year and a half I did this shit.
He's not starting from an open micer place.
Yeah, yeah,
he really
yeah.
Isn't.
Yeah.
It's a very different thing.
Yeah, but it's... See, this is another
everywhere
thing
he goes is a bringer show.
Yeah, but this is the thing, though. He knows
he's got
that...
people with him.
Hey, when T.I. first
and
started
he
rapping...
he should have people with him.
Yeah,
This is where he's starting at as T.I. He's not starting as like a San Diego open micer.
Did he tip last night?
I don't know.
We'll see if he makes
the
sponsor list
next week. I did watch his old
set. You know, I don't know if I'll do it, but maybe someone will compose an email and say like, hey, if you want to sponsor the Doorcast. Hey.
Hey.
Sure.
I told her, I was saying.
Comics looking out for other comics, man.
Yeah,
that's
we let him
actually,
up there
and invite
out.
To him, have him do the podcast. T.I., if you want to come down.
Well, we'll see. I don't know.
Hey, he might come down if he wants to talk comics.
Sure.
He could make a special. We could have a whole Door Guy special, and then he
TI presents the Doorcast.
Yeah.
Yay.
Wow. It, very interesting. I'll have my people
throw it out there.
Yeah. Reel it. My man Guam. My man Guam. I love, man.
Oh, can
I love
can I tell
Guam.
A TI story real
You're
quick?
You're here all the time. So early.
Yeah.
I love it. Yeah. Tell
okay,
the TI
I gotta
story.
Tell it this. Okay. If TI is gonna watch this, because he probably is, I want to just say thank you. This is a cool thing he
you
actually
think he
did.
Is?
No. Because we're talking about him, so somebody's going to say something.
I'm nervous.
But
now,
listen,
too.
I gotta tell you guys a quick story. So before I worked here, I used to work for Inside Jokes.
Okay.
And
in the theater.
In
the
theater.
Movie theater.
Yeah, and I worked in the VIP upstairs, so all the celebrities used to go up there, like everybody. Like,
didn't you do this story on the pod last time?
No.
Tony?
No. This is a different
Does
story.
Does this sound familiar?
No, I don't
remember. Okay.
Yeah. No, this is a different story.
Okay, great. Let's hear it.
So anyways, T.I. goes up there with his family and a bunch of, you know, other famous people up there. I think Chris Brown was up there. They're all hanging out up in the VIP. And then when they left, I noticed that T.I. left a pair of sunglasses on his table.
Sure.
So I grabbed them and, you know, I said, oh, man, I got to get him back his glasses, right? So I literally was kind of like, you know, walking pretty fast. And I was like, T.I., hey, man, you left your sunglasses on the table. And he looked at me and he was like, I'll keep them, dog. And then I looked, dude, those things were like $550.
Did you sell them?
No, I kept them. I still have them. They're like $550.
Why did you wear them at work?
Huh? No, I still have them. I have a picture. I'll bring a picture. But I just wanted to share that
story.
Do you
ever wear them? You
Every
should rock
now and
them.
Then. Yeah, I got them. You know, they're cased up and. You know, nice.
You should rock them, man.
Yeah. No, but I just want to say, I mean, that was very nice gesture because it's not like they were like some cheap $5, you know what I'm saying, sunglasses.
Sure.
He was just like, yeah, come on, dog. You could have them. It's fine. Whatever.
Aw, that was
you know.
His tip.
Yeah. So that's a little TI story I wanted to tell.
TIP.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's get, good. That's yeah. a good, yeah.
Yeah, that's a cool little story.
I want to bring back a segment of the week, the Don't Be That Guy of the Week, and I want to apply it to the guy that Guam had to throw down onto the ground and wrestle.
Oh, yeah.
Don't be that fucking guy.
For Just sure. be cool, man. We can make it. It's so easy to come here and chill out. Everyone here is, like, good at their job enough that it's fine.
Yeah. I think the problem is when people get to that point of being drunk that they can't control the volume of their voice. That's the problem. Because they're having fun, but there's people that do this. I've noticed people always do this all the time. They're having such a good time that they have to communicate that to their friend. Mm-hmm. Like, oh, that's so funny. Yeah.
Did you hear?
Like, yeah, did you hear
Did
that?
You hear what they said?
Did you hear the same thing that I heard in the same room that we're sharing right now?
Yeah.
Can you believe?
Yeah.
They're saying what I'm
thinking. It's about connection, and that's just human.
Yeah.
They're having a good time, and they're just talking, and then that's wrong.
Yeah.
Bummer.
That's Luke's take.
That's going to be the low.
That's nice. Why shouldn't I have takes? I'm a host of something.
Oh, another thing, too. Can I say this real quick?
Hey, great. I was looking for more stuff in my phone. So,
I mean,
it could be about race or you know, or like anything else. Let's hear it.
Okay.
What did you take before this today, Guam?
This is Guam normal.
I had a big cup of coffee, so the caffeine's like that's something all jittery. And okay, so I gotta say this because I don't care if I die tomorrow. If there's any words of wisdom that I want to give to the comedians,
are we talking the higher up comedians?
No, we're talking about like open mic, nobody comedians.
Okay,
if you come to any comedy club in the country, guys. Listen to the door guys, okay? We're having this problem.
This. I think, yeah. This
I know, my whole thing is this. You guys, if you think about this, if you come to the Comedy Store or any other clubs, if you do something to get on one of the bad side of one of the
staff,
door people, the staff, you're done. Because we're just not going to want you around anymore.
There's a very nice boy who came in, who was young, who was like, hey, I'm here. I'm a comic. I want to hang out. He was like, but he's trying to be cool about it.
Yeah.
I was like, oh man, the shows haven't started yet. Maybe come back like, I don't know, 40 minutes after the show starts. And maybe we can start to let comedians in.
Yeah.
And that's how, like, and maybe, you know, and he was like, oh yeah, cool. Yeah. I'll just go out there. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. He was like he was very cute about it.
Aww.
Yeah.
Little 20 something blonde kid.
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah.
I remember those ambitious days.
Yeah.
Full of hope.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Joy.
He was like, okay. Yeah. Wearing like a good hoodie,
yeah,
you know, like, yeah, yeah.
Well, another thing too is that we gotta understand that being door guys here at the Comedy Store, there's comics that come here and they've been wanting to come here their whole life. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I hear that all the time. Like, even from regular people, they'll be like, dude, I've been wanting to come here my whole life. Like, I'm from Georgia or I'm from, dude, we get people from like South Africa. Like, I meet people from all over the world here. And then they finally come here. That's why I try to express about them, especially if they're comedians. I'm like you said, hey, man, just be cool.
There was a South African comedian here the other day.
Yeah, exactly.
It was like a little too hype, and I was like, calm down. She got it.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah. It was cool. And she had like too many people with her the first night, and the second night, I think it was just her and maybe one other comic friend. I was like, great, much better.
Yeah.
Figured it out.
Because we will take care of you guys just as long as you know what I'm saying? Just
totally.
Yeah. Another thing too with the comics is that, listen, guys, if the show's sold out, there's nothing we can do about it.
Most people get it.
Yeah. But
that's not hard.
They we're not trying to hurt your feelings. You know what I'm saying?
We're really not.
Yeah.
Like, when we're
trust
trying to
me.
Keep you think yeah. I'm personally just you trying to keep you out of the host
exactly.
battle? Fuck you.
Yeah.
I think that applies to audience members too, because audience members like they don't know, and so to tell them like greet with good energy, and you go, hey, just be quiet in the room, please.
Yeah.
And if you don't get it, if you have to be like, if you're talking in the thing and someone comes to talk to you, just take that, like, it's a very small L that you're taking. You're just like, oh, okay. And then you'll be great. Talk outside. Step outside and talk for a bad comic. If you don't like the comic, step outside. It's fine.
Yeah.
Agreed.
I'm exhausted.
And that's Luke's take.
Yeah.
All right. Can I say something? I got to say something.
Please. How are we doing on time? We got on time?
Hey.
Okay.
I got
don't
you.
Stress.
Don't worry.
All right, cool.
Don't stress. But I did want to say, look, guys, look. No, I just really want to say that I'm so happy that Neil Brennan is back. Like, he's one of my favorites to watch.
Cool.
Because
he
is such a good writer.
It is nice to have him back. You're right.
Yes.
Where's he been?
Not here because of COVID.
Here.
Oh, that's what it is. Okay.
Yeah.
I wonder why. I was like, man, he was here all the time. Then all of a sudden, he's just like nothing.
He's motivating to me. As much as he writes, it's inspirational.
Yeah, he has a good writing brain.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's I do enjoy his comedy.
I do too. Mm-hmm.
You know what my main motivation is every time I come here is when I get off the bus and then I see somebody like Sebastian pull up in a car and I'm like, yeah, one day I'm going to be able to rent one of those.
Yeah.
I'm going to rent one of those for one day and take it
big
around.
Big baller. Yeah.
I'm going to park it in the back.
It's not his shtick, but Sebastian's just not down to earth to me. Hmm. But like Jeselnik is, even though you would think he wouldn't be.
Mm.
But
Jeselnik's chill.
He's so chill.
Sebastian is just busy with he thinks about like his own family and shit like that.
Right.
Like he's focused on Sebastian. I don't blame him for that.
Yeah,
but
he got too many things going on.
He's got a lot. He's got a big family life, and he that's where he's the everyman. He's not like super down to earth in a comic way.
Mm.
I don't think
right.
but he is super down to earth in a person way.
Personal in his personal life.
Yeah. I think that's where it is, and that's where he gets all that humor, and that's why he crushes. Because people are like, why do people act this way?
Yeah.
Can we discuss, though, that his comedy crowd, a lot of them are people that have never been to a comedy show, and that he's really, like, the first comic that they've ever really kind of liked. And they're all kind of bro-y. Not all. A lot are very bro-y. And we had to kick them out, these guys that were clear Sebastian fans, and he was the only one they knew. And they're just rude because they don't get it.
Yeah, well, the whole thing about it, like, another thing people got to understand, a lot of people throughout their whole life only come to a comedy maybe once or twice.
Yeah.
I know,
majority,
it's wild,
it's one of those once-in-a-lifetime, that we're not a concert venue where people are, like, specifically coming to see
an
artist.
But even, we are, like, a concert venue because, I've been to a handful of I go to a concert maybe a couple every other, or every couple years I go to one.
Can I just say a quick thing? Side note? Not even a side note. I just have to say this because I've been noticing this.
Look, guys.
Guam has to say it.
You have to say this.
Someone is forcing him to say this.
The one thing that puts a smile on my face when
this
I leave this place,
thing,
this is the good thing, is when I see a group of people that first time ever coming to the Comedy Store.
Hell yeah.
And they're in the front talking and they go, why the fuck haven't we been coming to comedy shows? What the fuck? Like, they had such a good time. They were like, You mean this whole time I could have been coming to this place or watching comedy shows live?
I see people
live?
Come back. When,
yeah, and they're
when
just
they're,
like, oh my God, like that was
experience.
Like the funny,
yeah.
That was like the funniest thing
see
I ever
it's
did.
It's all an act, but
yeah.
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 But yeah, it is, it's really, that's a really, really nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like when you hear, like, I like when people are outside discussing, like, I really liked him. And they're like, you liked that? And he was like, yeah, he was interesting because of, yeah. And it's like, I really liked her. It's like, I didn't like her. And they talk about it.
Yeah,
I think
exactly.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They discuss. Because I always tell everybody, this is my personal opinion. I think stand-up comedy is like music. Everybody has their different taste of music.
Sure.
And just because you like hip-hop, that doesn't mean heavy metal's bad. Or, you know what I'm saying? That doesn't mean the same thing. Like, just because you like country, that doesn't mean you don't like pop music or vice versa.
Techno is
yeah.
bad.
Yeah. But you understand what I'm saying. People have different taste. So, you know.
What kind of comedy is techno?
Ooh, that's probably like the Gallaghers or...
But that doesn't
tops.
Line up, and there is good techno. You don't like techno?
I hate techno.
Okay.
Gives me a headache, and it's just like...
Well, I don't think you've ever been to... Have you been to, like, EDC or a big rave?
No, I'm good. Thank you.
No, no, because
she
you haven't...
She doesn't like it.
No, she hasn't experienced it, because yeah. A long time ago, I thought techno was trash until I went to a rave, and I was like, oh, this is fun. I get it now.
Big
with
speakers
the lights,
does
yeah.
a different thing to it.
Yeah.
Big speakers?
Really big speakers. Yeah. You feel... It feels different, and I... That's, I mean, yeah, that's the most argument.
And the drugs?
If you don't like it. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that's yeah. that's what he's talking about, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you gotta be on, I guess if I was on drugs, sure, it yeah. would be a lot more fun.
What kind of music do you like?
Yeah.
I like everything yes. except techno okay. and house music.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody has their own personal taste about stuff.
Yeah.
It, yeah, like comedy.
My personal opinion with my comedy, it's either you love me or you hate me, and that's the only way I would rather have. I don't want anybody to be in between with either you love me or you hate me.
Would it kill you to say, like, I am medium on you?
You're okay.
Oh,
well,
no.
You're a comic.
Oh,
I'm talking about a regular person.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Comedians, we have different opinions.
Sometimes you're bombing on purpose, and I go, I really like this.
Yeah.
And sometimes you're bombing on purpose, and I go, Guam.
Yeah, I know. Because I love taking those rough spots, man.
You crush, though. I yeah. do love it. Yeah, it's fun.
You were so somber last night on your set.
Oh, yeah.
Guam's been laying on the ground.
Yep.
Really, like the stool is holding him up by his arm. Guam's moving around. Guam's dynamic.
Yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't know he had back problems.
I know, exactly. Jesus. But so what are you? We got to wrap it up.
We got about 5 or 10. Yeah.
Okay. So here,
I'll tell you when.
Let's do this real quick.
It'll be
Jessica.
Obvious.
What's your favorite story about the store since you've been working here? Like, what's one thing you'll always remember? Because I got a good one that just happened.
Well, you started off while I think. Then.
Okay. So my story is something that just happened, and. You know, there is ghosts in here. I don't care what anybody says. I've seen 3 of them already. There's
Whoa.
Ghosts in this building.
Wow.
And that's a different episode.
Okay. You know, we've got some time.
I like Guam well, comes and yeah. takes over.
Yeah.
He is in charge.
Quick story. Okay. So
yeah,
quick story. Hopefully I'm going to try to rush through it. So I'm closing now Josh Adams Meyer show. I'm laying on the ground. And then I don't know if you guys were watching my set. But a piece of paper fell down from the ceiling, and it was just spinning so fast, it almost looked like a star. So I pointed to it, and I said, hey, you guys, Brody Stevens is here. And then people started clapping, and I was like, 818 till I die, right?
Wow.
And then afterwards, when I was leaving, me and Anthony were talking in the back. This girl, Lexi, comes up, and she's crying. And I go, girl, what's wrong? She goes, Guam, you don't remember? It's after midnight. And I go, what? She goes, oh, it's the anniversary of Brody's death.
Wow.
And then I talked to, I forgot who the sound guy was. He goes, dude, you know what? I was watching the whole show. That piece of paper only fell when you were on stage. And it was almost like, and I was going up last in the main room.
That's
and
really
like,
nice.
And
that's
I was all like,
spot.
Yeah, dude, I was like, wow. And I was all like, man, dude, that just inspired the hell out of me.
That's
yeah.
really so, special, actually.
Yeah. So that was the one thing that I wanted to share. And just quick thing, guys. You know, I'm not gonna live forever, but they are gonna have my funeral here at the Comedy Store. Just I'm gonna make arrangements for that. So
okay.
just to let you guys know that.
Oh, that'll be fun.
Well,
yeah,
we'll bury you under the basement, so you'll always be.
I want my coffin on the front patio.
Your ashes. We'll have an
like,
urn.
They're having a funeral.
Where would you like an urn, Guam? If we were going to put Guam's urn somewhere, where would you like?
Where,
I would like
you,
mine
where?
Uh, on the back bar near that first post where the Brody Day is hanging out.
Yeah.
Well, here's another quick Brody story. There's a declaration, official city declaration of Brody's Day.
Yeah.
And it's taped over the emotional support hotline that was set up for it's the most comedy store. It's blocking the number. I will show it to you after. Maybe we'll post it on the socials.
Oh my, are you suicidal? Well, now it's Brody Day.
Yeah, yeah. And it's literally like, no, don't worry about it. You'll get a day.
So funny.
You'll get a day.
Yeah.
But my urn would be my roast battle spot.
Oh, at the rope at the belly room?
Right where I said, right there.
Hell yeah.
They'll put it, hang it right there, and they'd be like, Guam used to, this where he started, this where he ended.
Respect the rope.
Where would you put your urn, Jessica, here?
Maybe in the main room of the green room in the main room.
Oh, yeah, that'd be nice,
because I'm always just there being nosy.
Yeah. Yeah.
I would put, you either there or right at the curtain entrance.
Yeah.
Okay, quick idea. I'm going to get the layout of the store. And all the door people, we got to pick our urn spots.
Please do this. We will definitely post that on social media.
Yeah, definitely.
Brought to you by Thirster and maybe a rapper. Who knows? Jessica Wellington and Guam Felix, thank you for doing the pod. Jessica, where can people find you? What podcast do you have to plug? What's your socials?
Okay, yes. I'm at Jess Wellington. And then the number 2, at Jess Wellington 2 on everything. Please follow me. That helps us more than anything. Mm-hmm. The Liars Club's going to be making its debut again soon. I probably shouldn't be talking about it yet.
It's a renewal, revamp. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm excited.
I forgot to mention, every Wednesday, free show at the Up Next in the Belly Room, the Door Guy show, where all of us go up and we're pretty good or whatever.
Yeah, sometimes T.I. pops in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had a beautiful story about Bobby Lee, but Guam will. I guess I'll have to do it next time when you're not here, and I can.
Yeah, yeah. It was.
Sorry,
it's a Guam heavy episode.
I drank too much coffee. I drank too much coffee, guys. I drank too much coffee. Sorry.
Where can people follow you and find
He's
you?
He's looking it up.
Hold on, no. I gotta get the date right for this. Okay, guys.
Oh.
So I'm gonna be at the Tacoma Comedy Club on March 24th, which is a Thursday, with Jimmy Shin, and then I'm gonna be doing a casino that Saturday, which is going to be the 27th.
Tacoma stand up.
Yeah. in Seattle. The Clearwater, I think it's called the Clearwater Casino.
You'll do great there.
Yeah. And I'm going to be doing the showroom with Jimmy Oyang that Saturday.
Just a road pro.
Yeah. All the people in Washington, what's up?
Cool.
And I live here, so if you guys want to come see me, just ask for Guam at the
And if you want to sponsor the podcast, come by, drop $5, drop $3,000, you know, like just drop some.
Yeah.
And we'll shout you out. We'll shout out your handle. It's all good.
We'll shout you out every day if you give us a few thousand.
Thanks for producing, Tony. We'll see you next time, Comedy Store Doorcast.
And that's Luke's take.
Oh, boy.
I had such a clean out. Damn. Darn.
That was so fun.
That was good. Thank you, guys.